Hello all and welcome back to my YouTube channel. For those of you that are new here, I want to say a big hello, and for those that are returning, I want to say a big thank you and thank you for watching my recent videos. Now today's haul is a little bit different. Yes, it's still a high street retail haul, but the big difference for me is the types of items that I've been buying today. I am today talking to you about all things lingerie and swimwear, which to be honest is probably one of the hardest things for me to shop for, and one of those things that I often just put off and off because I feel like shopping for swimwear, lingerie often leaves you feeling not very good about yourself and your body. But I'm here to talk to you about these items because honestly, these swimwear items, the style of the swimwear is the type of item that I buy in year in and year out purely because of what it does for the female figure. And I normally buy these items from ASOS, but I saw these in H&M. It's my first time buying them from H&M. And honestly, the fit of these swimwear items are honestly so, so flattering. My friend has also bought this swimwear as well. She's got a slightly different body shape to me and it's also flattering on. So I thought I have to talk to you guys about this swimsuit because I genuinely want to share this swimsuit with you, because if this swimsuit makes myself and my friend feel better about our form and how we feel in a swimwear, if I can bring that to you guys, I'm like, this is exactly what my channel's about. Because my channel's about clothes and fashion, talking to you about them, but also bringing clothes to you that make me feel good and that I hope will transcend, and you will purchase those and also they will make you feel good. So that's why I'm talking to you about this swimwear, because I just had to share this item. And then alongside that, I was thinking, if I'm going to do a swimwear haul and I'm literally throwing myself into the deep end with how I feel about showing basically the internet and potentially the world, I'm putting my body out there to you guys, I thought, why not also do a lingerie haul? And the reason for that, if you have been here from the very start of my YouTube channel, you'll remember like in the months and months ago where I did a H&M haul and I bought some bras, and they were very similar to the Skims bras that I have been paying them, which are quite expensive and have also been out of stock. And I remember buying them and I thought, I think these are a good dupe. And lots of you actually bought those items and I thought, do you know what? I need to talk about some of the bras that I'm buying, because the key thing about these bras are that they're comfortable, they are affordable, they wash well. Often when you're wearing bras all the time, they don't always wash very well. So yeah, here I am bringing my thoughts and reviews to you. But with that comes a lot of trepidation because I am genuinely scared to be putting my body out there. So guys, please be nice in the comments because I am very, very nervous to be putting this out. But I really do hope you enjoy this haul. And yeah, I can't wait to get into this with you. So yeah, my first bra item. Now, one of the things I must say about my bras is when it comes to comfortability, I have the bras which are really sexy lingerie, you know, the underwire, the lace. But for an everyday bra, they are not very comfortable. And us girls know that when we come home from work, which actually hasn't really happened very much because we've been working from home, we just like to take our bras off, feel comfortable, feel relaxed. It's like the ultimate feeling. And I feel like taking your bra off after a day of work is a bit similar to taking your face mask off. It's that same kind of relief and feeling. So obviously with having been working from home, I often find I tend to go towards not wearing a bra very much, which does not necessarily work for those Zoom calls. You know, those impromptu, unscheduled Zoom calls that you get and you're not wearing a bra and you're feeling a little bit free. It just doesn't work. So what I wanted to find was bras which gave me that kind of comfortable feeling. So often aren't underwired. They're comfortable and they're supportive and also seamless. I think the key thing for me is I never really like to be able to see my bra through a top, but then also I don't necessarily want to be braless in front of people, and I especially want to cover my nipples as well. So it's trying to get that happy medium in a bra, and this for me is what this bra is. Now it's very hard to show a bra in the camera when it doesn't have any underwire because it doesn't have any shape, but what I will do is make sure I show you in the cutaways here, and I am very nervous to be putting those cutaways up. But the great thing about this bra here is $17.99. I've got this in a black and I've also got it in a nude color as well. What I do like about this bra is this bra became sold out very, very quickly, which shows that a lot of people are also enjoying these styles bras. But one of the things I said when I did the first haul was about the fact that it basically looks like the Kim K Skims bra range, where it's literally just a pure triangle. It's the material for me. Now, what I love about this is that the bottom of it is really kind of quite strong, quite structured, which actually gives you that support underneath your cup without it really trying to. It kind of gives you that underwire support without actually having that underwire feeling where the bone sits underneath your breast. So that's what I love about the material here. And then the actual triangle bit itself is a slightly different material. It is still quite taut, it is still quite structured, so it isn't flimsy. But what I do like about it, now I don't know if you do follow Kim Kardashian, she's famous for having that kind of, that masking tape. You know, when she used to go braless, she used to have like a bit of like parcel tape that she would tape from her nipples all the way up, which would give her that support. And I think that's where she kind of really kind of designed that bra. And this is where this bra does the same. It has that nice thick strap that everything's completely seamless, so you literally cannot see it under an item of clothing. But it's got that material which gives you that fit kind of hold in the structure. So it's cupped underneath, but then it pulls your bra up to give you that kind of structure, and it's just all the way seamless and it's adjustable. Now, the only thing when I was buying these bras in H&M, which kind of put me off, was the fact that these style of bras are not sold in the traditional 32A, 32B. They are literally sold in a small, medium, large, extra large. I think there's an extra small as well. So for me, I was a little bit, can a bra really be supportive enough when their size ranges are just so limited? So, you know, for $17.99, I took the jump, and I have to say, I bought a medium. I'm a size 32E/34D. I bought a medium. It fits really well. The fact that it's got this hook and eye clause at the very back, which means that basically you can just, you know, adjust the strength that you require around your back. So it does have that adjustability. And then the straps are really comfortable because as they're seamless, they don't really cut into you. There is quite a thick kind of bra at the back with the typical adjustable strap, and that is quite thick, and sometimes I do feel that a bit. But for $17.99, these are absolutely brilliant, and I have worn these again and again. And what I like about this is actually, I just show you up here, is that it literally still looks brand new. Now, I have bought the Skims bra. I had only the black one because I couldn't buy any of the others because they sold out. But the one thing I will say about that is after a few washes, the black goes into a grey. It looks really worn. And I, you know, these aren't the most sexiest of bras. So when I'm going to be wearing this bra, I don't want it to be looking tired as well, because I don't want to be looking in front of my man with a tired looking grey old bra, which isn't even sexy to him in the first place. So this is what I will say. I absolutely love the value of these. I'm so happy with these. And what I will say is that they bring this version out every single time they turn around the seasons. So, for example, this item has been out of stock for a while, but they also do it with the kind of seam, with a kind of a ribbed effect. They do a cotton. They've also now brought out the range where they put a little bit of padding below, also a push-up bra, but it's the same kind of structure. So what I will do in the comments or in the description below is link this particular bra. I'll also link the ones which are similar, which I am now going to purchase, because I just generally get such a good wear of these. I think every season for this type of price, I'll probably, you know, spring, summer, winter, autumn, I'll probably buy a couple of new bras. But to be fair, you know, that might be a bit superfluous, because I reckon this is, I bought this back in autumn and this has carried me through, and we're here in spring. So yeah, you know, don't be like me, who's an absolute shopping addict. But yeah, love these bras, and I really do hope that you guys will purchase these and feel the same. Now, the next set of bras is kind of like what I would call a junior version to the bra that I just showed you. And the reason I say it's a junior version is, I'll come a bit closer to the camera and show you, but this is a very kind of, very flimsy kind of bra. I mean, you can see that from the way that structure looks in comparison to this one. It is much more flimsy, but with that comes a lot of comfortability. Now, I wear this bra and I generally feel like I'm not wearing a bra. It is just so, like, airy. It's hard to explain, but what I like about it is the material is like a slinky effect. It's quite slinky. It's very, very soft, which is lovely. It's soft to the touch. And I think also, if you've got another half, when he touches you across your breast, it feels like it's barely there. It feels like you're getting the full work of the breast with this very soft, sexy touch fabric over the top, but it is still giving you that support from the elastic underneath. And the way that it's cut, it's that same triangle effect again. But what I like about it is the way the cut is kind of curved underneath the breast, which still makes it look sexy, but it also supports you. And yeah, these are just brilliant. I say these are like the junior trainer bras because they kind of remind me of the trainer bra that I used to have when we, you know, first started growing boobs as a child. So yeah, so what I will say about this is it doesn't give you as much support, but you do notice that the bra is there and it is very, very comfortable. What I like about these is that they still have that sexy kind of edge, and I hope I'm showing you that in the cutaway. You might be looking and be like, girl, that's not sexy. Hopefully not. But what I like about it is that you can still wear like a cotton or a linen button shirt, have it kind of undone a little bit, and then you get a glimpse of this. And because it's got like the little shine to it, it's still quite sexy. And the way it cuts, it kind of pushes your boobs in together a little bit. So I do really, really like that. And I got this in a black and a nude. And now the reason I got this in a black and a nude is purely because they came as a twin pack. Now I will link these. I got these some times ago, so I'm not too sure if they're still in stock. But what I will do is I will scour H&M and see if there's anything similar. Because as I say, they keep the same kind of shape and style, they just slightly change it and tweak it over the way. And one thing I must notice about the bras on H&M is that they go out of stock so quickly, and then they just kind of just sit there out of stock for a little bit, and then I don't see them come back into stock, and then I see as something that's slightly different come back in that gets launched or is new in. And I feel like maybe I am just a little bit slow to the jump. Maybe I didn't realise just how popular H&M underwear is. So maybe I'm last on the train. But, you know, if I'm last on the train, I'm still happy about it. I'm still glad I found it. And I'm happy to be showing you guys what my honest thoughts are with this. So I got these. Once again, the sizing of these is small, medium, large, extra small, extra large. I got these in a medium. So I think if you're ever in the D or the C category and your back is between a 32 to a 34, maybe a 36, I'm not 100% sure there, but I reckon a medium really covers you well. And even though I was a bit concerned that you had this like the small, medium, large and not it really covering enough, I do understand why they've done that. And H&M obviously tested this across loads of women. So, you know, they are doing something right. But $17.99 for two bras, fantastic price, wash really well. You know, we're nearly two seasons in and they look brand new. So yeah, I will definitely link these. And if I can't find something that's in stock, I will also link something similar as well. I'll leave you the link, which is still out of stock, so that when it comes back in, you can purchase them. But yeah, I'll put something similar as well down underneath as well. Now, to cut a little bit of the underwear situation, I thought I'd bring in the swimwear, because I feel like sometimes we can get too bogged in the lingerie. But I did talk to you about this swimwear, and this swimwear is this item here. Now this item is £20, it's £19.99. I feel like, you know, Zara, if you watch my Zara hauls, a lot of the price points are around £29.99 for Zara. And I feel like with H&M, they stick between £17.99 and £19.99, which is great. You know, it's £10 cheaper than Zara. But this is £19.99. Now, let me just show you this. Now, I don't know, it depends on where you are in life and how you feel about your body and your body size and just in general. I feel like some of you are going to look at this and think, no girl, that's not for me, I just love the bikinis. And some of you are like, yes, one swimsuit, not the two-piece, just the one. But I personally love this. Now this style for me is amazing. The reason I love this style is because it is low cup, so you're still showing the female form by being able to show your breasts and a little bit of cleavage. I love the back. Now what I will say is I go for this style of swimsuit all the time. I buy it in ASOS often. They always stock this style. This is my first time with H&M, but the reason I buy this style is because it just complements a female form. Now what I love about this particular swimsuit is the back. Now, let's just have a look at the back. Now the cut of a swimsuit is so important. The reason being is the swimsuit. Now I often thought a swimsuit to look good was all about just the pattern, maybe how the cut has been a little bit. But it was all about just what the swimsuit looked like, which was what made a good swimsuit. However, that is not the case. For me, what makes a good swimsuit is exactly the cut of the swimsuit and how it complements the female form. Now, what I mean by that is that, for example, the reason that I love this style of swimsuit is purely because it tries to emphasize the curves. So it tries to emphasize the bust, the hips, and has a nice cut to make your leg look a little bit longer. And this is what I love about this swimsuit in particular. The reason being is that the cut at the front is just the right amount of depth. It is quite low cut, as you can see, but it's the way that it cuts round. It's not a straight down, it's not a harsh line. It's a little bit curved to give you a fuller looking bust rather than trying to just let your bust do all the work. So that's why I like the front of it. Why I like the back of the swimsuit is the way that the actual cut is done at the back. Now, as you can see, it's quite hard to see on black. Maybe if I show you on the green one that I've got here, because of course, if I love something, I buy it in every color. But it's the way that the straps go. The straps don't go straight down. They actually come, see if I can hang it off my arm. They come inwards. So what that does, by it coming inwards, it makes the back of your back look much more slight. It's, if you've got a slightly broader back, by having those straps come in, it brings the eye in to your waist. And that's what I love. The second thing that I love about it is this band that's just here. This kind of thick band that you can see in the middle is amazing. Reason being, because it emphasizes, it brings the eye to your waist, the middle bit of your waist, which should be the smallest part of your body. If it's not, the band, by doing that, it brings the eye and it sucks it in, which I just absolutely love. And then lastly, why I love this swimsuit is actually how high the leg is. Now, Joe, my other half, is not into a high-legged swimsuit. This isn't too high. We all know the fashion from kind of two summers ago, you know, when we were actually allowed to go on holiday, where they had the really, really high swimsuits. Works for some people, doesn't always work. But the reason why the high leg swimsuit is in is because if it's cut well around the leg, it can make you, it can elongate your legs to make them look longer. And then it's also a bit more complementary to your hips, which are often wider. So yeah, if you can see here, the way this is cut, it goes up quite high, but it's the shape of it. And that is just why I just love this swimsuit. So hopefully you'll be able to see me modeling them in the cutaway. Now, as I say, when I like something, I buy it in every single color. It is literally one of my worst traits. But the thing for me is, if you find something that makes you feel good, then buy it in every color, seriously. Because there are so many trends that we often follow and we wear them and we don't necessarily feel our very best, but you buy them because you like the trend, you like the style, you like what you're expressing. But if you find something that makes you feel good, then hun, buy it in every color because you should feel good. And I think it's so rare to buy a swimsuit that makes you feel okay about your body. And this is what that is for me. And I've got it obviously in the white as well. Now obviously white is a much tougher color to wear because often it makes you look larger, but here it is in the white and I love that as well. And I've also got it in the green as well. Now all of these colors are still in stock when I was filming this. They are $19.99, all of the colors. Sometimes it's weird, isn't it? Some colors are more expensive than others, but they're all $19.99. I got this in a size 10. Now when I purchased these, I did get them in a size 8, 10 and 12 because you just never know with swimsuits. What I will say is I am a size 8 normally up top. I am normally a size 10, sometimes an 8 if it's a little bit larger, but normally a size 10 on the bottoms. I do have quite a curvy bum and bigger thighs, so I often sometimes grab the 12 because I think I might need that extra amount for my bum. But the 10 worked well, and what I will say is sometimes when you're doing the cut of the back, don't let the cut be too baggy, because when you get into the water, it often stretches. And you know, nobody wants that kind of like nappy kind of baggy look at the back. So I would say get the size that really does feel like it fits and you'll be well away. But yeah, I love these swimsuits. And like I say, I've got a version of these from ASOS, which I love. But I just love the cut of this so much more. The way the straps did it at the back, the band, and just how the leg is and the kind of curved on the... Yeah, I just loved it. I'd be sitting here talking to you about it for ages, but I just love these. All we need now is Boris just to, you know, allow us to travel a little bit further than Portugal and we can actually wear these items out. I mean, I am off to Norfolk next week and I have booked a hut on the beach and I was looking forward to taking our little puppy Lulu out on the beach and maybe a little bit of sunbathing, you know, throw the swimsuit on with a nice linen shirt and read a book. But typical UK weather, it is forecasted to rain the entire time. And all I hear about is how the UK are going to have a heat wave. And that's going to be the following week. So I'm going to have a week of rain. And then I'm going to come home and it's going to be... Now, leading on to my last item of the haul is another bra. Now, the reason I had to show you this bra is for so many different reasons. So for someone like myself, who's a 32E / 34D, I often have to wear strapless bras. I can't always go braless, especially because my nipples tend to kind of poke out quite a lot if I don't And one thing I must say about strapless bras is I find them so incredibly uncomfortable. I feel like I have to have so much support that, first of all, the straps are often normally thicker than this. The support all the way around the front is normally so boned and so heavy and dense that it makes you feel uncomfortable to kind of bend forward. It's just, you know, I get why they have to be so tight, because they have to keep everything up. It's got no strap to hold it up. I just find them so uncomfortable, and I tend to not wear a bra when I should be wearing a strapless bra, purely because they're so uncomfortable. And this is why I love this bra. This bra is comfortable. This bra is comfortable for someone with the size breasts like myself. And can I just talk to you about another thing? Can we just take a look at this colour nude? Can we just take a look? Take a moment and look. This for me was groundbreaking. When I went to buy this bra, they do it in so many different colours. They've got it obviously in the white and black, but they have like 5 variations of nudes. I was taken aback. For a high street store to have that level of inclusivity, bravo. Like, thank God. Like, where is the rest of the stores? I like to wear a nude item, especially that's in something that's white, but often, you know, in bras like this, it's coming just this one colour, which is often a lot lighter than my skin tone. Same with this other nude bra. This one's obviously a little bit darker than my skin tone. If I have a little bit of a suntan, they'll be pretty much the same colour. But this nude is much more inclusive. It's closer to my skin tone. And that's why I was just literally blown away by this. But enough of talking about that. But what you've got here is you've got the underwire. So you've got the support of the bra. But what you actually have is the seamless aspect of it. So the other thing I find with strapless bras is often the underwire is really pronounced, and it's often really shown in a tight top. Now you've got a seamless top, you've got a seamless bottom to cover over the bottom. And the other thing that I like about this is the fact that because this seamless top is here, it's not making the bone feel too uncomfortable, which is why I like it. I tend to find that the elastic itself tucks under into your skin a little bit, which actually gives you a little bit of softness to the bone, which is what I like. But yeah, it comes with straps as well, so you could still wear it with straps over your shoulders, do the crisscross, do the halter neck. But I intend to wear this purely as a strapless. It is just so comfortable. And obviously I've shown you it in the cutaway, but yeah, I love this. And this is priced at $19.99. Once again, a really good price point. I often found myself when trying to find strapless bras, which were inclusive of my size breasts, I'd often spend, you know, £40-£50 thinking, yeah, if I spend more money, it's gonna be more comfortable, it's gonna be more supportive. And I just didn't really find it. I remember spending £50 on one of the Wonder Bra bras, and it's so uncomfortable. So this is why I love this, and the price is just amazing. So this is why I'm really happy with this bra. And also the other thing about this, which is important and very key, is that these are done in your typical bra sizes. So I got this in a 34D. They didn't have a 32E when I was looking in stock, but the 34D definitely fits me more than enough. I can obviously make it tighter if I need to, which I haven't actually had to have with this one. So maybe if you are in the 32 zone, think about going down one cup size but jumping up to the 34, because I think it will still fit you. But yeah, absolutely love this. So my next item is this satin night slip lingerie item. Now this item I bought on the off chance a good couple of months ago, but the reason I bought this in is because this has just come back into stock. They've relaunched it again for the new season. Now I am definitely going to be buying myself another one of these items, because I have worn this to death. And the only thing I would say is I wish H&M would bring this out in a different color to just black, because I love the black, but I would also love it in a navy blue, a beige, a cream, because I honestly love this. It's so comfortable. The amazing thing about this is it's $12.99. the price point is honestly amazing. It is super light, which is fantastic for the summer. But that being said, I wore it in winter. I just put over a dressing gown. It is very sexy without being too sexy, if you get what I mean. Why it's very sexy is because of this real light lace in here, the adjustable straps, which means that you could have it as low as you want across your breast or as high as you want. So if you're feeling very modest, you can adjust the straps and have it up really high, so it just is very cute. Or if you want this to be a little bit more sexier, you can just drop the straps down just a little bit more, which gives you a little bit more breast, a little bit more cleavage. It is very, very sexy. And also the length of it is just perfect. It's not too short, but it's also not touching your knee. So you're not gonna look like a grandma. Because the thing is about lingerie is my other half, I love comfortable items, but my other half always says, oh, you've got your middle-aged pajamas on. So this is where we are compromising, because it is ultra comfortable. I absolutely love it. And for $12.99, I could not show you. I thought, why not show you this during, amongst the bras, amongst the swimwear? I feel like this is a good place. I can't just drop a night slip into a, you know, your summer dresses haul. So I thought it was a perfect place. But yeah, I got this in a size small. So I'm normally a size 8 to 10. Size small, $12.99, bargain. Honestly, you need to try this. And if you do buy it, let me know your thoughts in the comments, because I know you're going to love it. But yeah, that is the end of today's haul. I hope you've enjoyed it. I hope you found it helpful. And I hope you found some items which actually become essential items in your wardrobe that you will actually enjoy over the next few months and actually buy it again and again. I do hope that this has come over okay. As I said, I was so scared to be filming this haul, but I honestly do think the fear was worth it to show you some of these items that I have genuinely been buying that I love and I wear daily on a regular basis. But yeah, it would be great if you could let me know in the comments what you thought about today's haul, whether you found it useful, whether you found it helpful, whether you would like to see more hauls in the future of a similar nature about essential items that I buy, that I wear day in, day out, that I think are great. And yeah, anything in general that you would love to share, because I really did like the comments and the chats that I had in the comments in the last video, and it is really nice to be getting to know you all a little bit more as this carries on and we all grow together. But yeah, if you've loved today's haul, if you found it useful, it would be amazing if you could give me a thumbs up, and you could hit subscribe if you'd love to see more videos in the future. But I thank you very much for joining us today, and I very much look forward to seeing you again soon. I hope you are having a lovely day, have a lovely week, and enjoy your weekend, and I will speak to you soon. Take care, everyone. Bye.